All right, folks, God bless you guys, and welcome to This Is It, 4321 Before the Fire. Y'all are going to freak out. I'm freaking out. Christ's purpose was to make one new man from the two, thus making peace. You're in a twin system. Okay, guys, have y'all noticed, like, there's a little bit of this tiff thing going on? Yeah, the Lord told me the other day that I had to stand against this guy, James the Planner. He seems like a really sweet guy, and I feel really bad for him, and I do, and I've been praying for him, but there's this polarization over at James's channel. Is all these people from the past, I've seen a lot of them, and they are all Jonathan Kleck haters. They literally, if you go to their channels, you can see the hate. The Bible says anyone that hates his brother is a murderer at heart, and Christ is not in them, but they're over there saying how they represent Christ. Okay, that's fine. Good for you. Okay, I've been producing what the Lord's been showing me since 2002. Vatican's a snake. Largest altar in the world is a dead sheep. There's a hieroglyph of Akhenaten and Nefertiti that shows a serpent race killing a sheep race within the host body system. My own wife gave me a card with the serpent eating a sheep. I have right there on the wall a plaque from a guy named Marcel. He drew a caricature of me with a dead sheep on my head with the serpent eating me. I walked into Starbucks. I said, Alex over there is going to draw a picture of me. When he does, he's going to put an image of a dead sheep on the image. He did. So there's obviously a serpent race eating a sheep race. It's stupid obvious now. And I'm the guy that the Lord God used to do that and to bring the Word of God as delivered from the Lord God to myself, just like Paul said, I was taught the scriptures by no man, but by the Lord himself. Now, that being said, now let me show you what's going on. It is documented, yes or no, that the past couple, you know, videos, I do not do these type of videos where the Lord told me, you're going to go stand against them because this is hurting the sheep. They're getting the sheep to drop their guard, James's, and all the people supporting James. I'm just going to call them a brood of vipers, just like John the Baptist would. Y'all are a brood of vipers. Now, watch this. Let me show you the way the Lord answered me. James is saying, oh, you're not going to go meet the Lord in the clouds and to be with him in the air. It's not what it means. I'm like, dude, you are butchering scripture. You've been butchering scriptures, telling people not to be waiting, not to be looking. If you're looking for him, if you're waiting for him, you're saying by default that he's not here. No one said that at all, James. You said those words, and they are so erroneous. It's insane. Now, okay, here we go. The Lord told me to go stand against them. Have y'all seen me do two videos in a row where I'm just like, that's it? No. Let me show you how the Lord supernaturally is going to answer them, the brood of vipers, again. Just like he supernaturally sent me to lay hands on Karen Sullivan by showing me a billboard, put your money where your miracle is, or showing Jim, hey, Jim, you were targeted as a child. You were molested because, you know, that race of beings. Here it is hidden in the images of the Virgin. I'm going to show it to him. That's when he made his appeal. But then, unfortunately, just like Matthew 13 says, some things don't work out for some folks. Okay, so now I'm going to show you exactly what the Lord just showed me. And if I was all the sheep, pay attention, because the Lord's trying to get you to look up now. I'm standing against the brood of vipers, Gene and his whole channel. I'm sorry, Gene, him. Gene, you're a whole nother thing, dude. You're, God have mercy on you, and I mean that. God have mercy on you. James, I pray for you, dude. I really pray and hope something happens where you just like, okay, you know what? I was wrong. But let me show you how the Lord answered James when James said, oh, no, you're not going to go. You're not going to be in a cloud. You're not going to disappear in a cloud. Let me show you what the Lord showed me. Then I'm going to show you what he showed me today. It is beyond supernatural. It's an answer to the questions. Just watch. Just watch. So it's an answer to the whole thing that's going on. It's insane. It's kind of scary. Here we go. Ready? So here's my question to the whole brood of vipers. So, if someone is doing a video saying if you're waiting on the Lord and you're looking for him and waiting for him, you're tempting him, and the Lord tells me, Jonathan, you will go over there and you will stand against him, I'm like, okay, absolutely, and the Lord confirmed it, so I went and did it. Okay, so, if I went and did that, and then the Lord just happened to walk me into an art gallery where there's a group of people, like proselytes, and they're going up in an orderly procession to a rock, with a cross on it and light emanating from it, suggesting like all these people are going to the source of what saved them. What is them? So I'm showing you all the painting. I'll show it to you again. It's called the procession. All these people are going up to the rock. Well, didn't the Lord give me two houses of the same rock? I'm not going to go through all the rock stuff. Y'all should know that Jonathan Kleck, his whole purpose was to show the world what being on the rock is. 100% nylon, 100% no lion. For those, I'm talking to my sheep right now that I'm protecting. Everybody, y'all all know that. It's the most obvious, ridiculously obvious thing in the world. Superhuman, angel, demon. Okay, kick the demon out by inverting the world. See the truth. Make your profession. Be made whole in Christ. One spirit. Superhuman, angel, demon goes away. And Christ's Holy Spirit takes up full residency in you. That's what it all looks like. Okay, so then the Lord shows me go into this art gallery in front of witnesses. And it shows an orderly procession of people going to Christ. Okay, well, James is saying, oh, you shouldn't be looking for him. You shouldn't be waiting for him. He's also saying that if you think you're going up in the clouds, you've got it wrong. There's not a physical appearance of Christ. Even though the Bible says every eye will see him. Even though the words out of his mouth fly directly in contradiction to the scriptures. He's saying, oh, no, no, believe me. Oh, you must hear my words. He's pleading with you to hear his words. Okay. So the Lord tells me to watch some movie called Arrival. I've never seen it, don't know what it's about, don't want to watch it. But the Lord tells me, I want you to watch it, and I'll watch it. Here's a scene for it from it that shows a higher power, an entity that shows up on the earth, and they're all over the earth in the shape of whatever this is. And that entity communicates with a woman that's a linguist, and he says, we are a weapon, a door in time, a door in time. That's the weapon. Can you imagine what the weapon for the Lord God is against his enemy? Yeah. You leave through the door and then you burn the rest. I'm the before the fire guy. Here's the clip from that scene, from that movie called Arrival. Then I'm going to show you what the Lord did today to confirm it. I'm the guy that stood in opposition to James. I'm sorry, James, because you seem like a nice guy and all that, but I tried my best to just be as kind as I could, say, please stop, don't do this, you're hurting sheep. But you persisted. Okay, now, watch this. So here's a ship, and, you know, these are this entity that showed up. Their weapon is a door in time in order to save, you know, help save a bunch of people, and that's what the plot is. I'm going to fast forward through it. Here these entities are, and then they, when it's time, once the job's been done, they all turn to clouds and leave. Here it is. Now, I wonder what the odds are that in a movie that the Lord told me to watch out of nowhere, that all these higher entities that are a door in time are turning to clouds and disappearing. I mean, just think about that. What are the odds that this higher power, a door in time, they're turning to clouds and leaving, and I am standing against someone who has a channel named James Supplanter, and I'm standing against the words he's saying, and he's going in direct contradiction to the Bible, and then the Lord shows me this. You know that this is a miracle, don't you? This is like when I was driving to Houston, and the Lord showed me the billboard, put your money where your miracle is, and I would end up sharing that with Karen Sullivan, that if you want your miracle to get well, that's what you'll have to do. Put your money where your mouth is, put your money where your miracle is, and that's why she got her miracle. So now, here is a cloud, here is a higher entity.
Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore comfort one another with these words.
Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to X out of that, and I'm going to show you what happened today, because this is absolutely insane. I want you to see Psalm 68. I'm going to have Max McQueen read it in just a minute. But I want to remind you of the David Bowie video game called Omicron, where they put the word up right here in the corner. And it's in the whole, I did videos on it. The whole thing about the game is you go into the game and it says the goal of the game is if you don't find the serial killer before the game ends, you lose your soul. And when you go into the video game, you get turned upside down, just like when we came into this dimension, we get turned upside down. The first thing you see is a stripper doing a pole dance. It's not very hard to figure out. Neither shall you touch it, lest you die. So they're mocking all the sheep that came in. He's obviously the serpent race. And they have the word up right there for you to see, because the only way to find the serial killer is to turn everything up the other direction. Isaiah 29:15-16. Woe unto them who go to great plans to hide their works from the Lord. Their works are in the darkness. They say, who seeth us? Who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. Shown it to you over and over. That's why the dead sheep is the virgin in the story. Okay, this is supernatural data. Now watch this. So David Bowie's got this scene called Omicron. And when you go in, and I'll just prove it, the whole time they leave the word up there to mock the sheep because they know the sheep are too stupid to look up to get out of the system that we're in called the flesh. In order for us to skip break free of it, I turn the virgin upside down. It's a dead sheep. The night I got saved, the Lord told me, read the tags in your shirt, 100% nylon. Doesn't make any sense. He said, turn it upside down. It was 100% no lying, 100% truth. That's how you see Jesus. Now watch this. Okay, here we go. David Bowie, Omicron. So you go in, it turns upside down, and there's the dancer. And I don't want to play a lot of it, but it says, Asheroth, the head of the demons, you've got to find the serial killer, but no one knows where he is, but they leave the word up there. Okay, now, again, there's a movie out that came out just a little while back. It's called Nope, N-O-P-E. Jordan Peele, the same guy that did the movie where everyone has their own evil doppelganger called Us. And it says it's 9/11 when you just simply trace in the word us. It makes the 9 and 11 us. Okay. The same guy that did that movie, Us, he did a movie called Nope. And there's a cloud, and the cloud's there all the time, and the cloud is really a hunter, and don't look up. So they're front-loading everybody. Don't look up. Don't look up. There's a series out now called a Prime Video thing that came up the other day. Corey showed it to me. It's called Don't Look Up. So the Lord showed me this, and while I'm getting ready to show you the miracle from Psalm 68 that happened today with Corey, Zach, and myself. And while I'm getting ready to show this to you, I'm getting my desktop ready, and the Lord gets a hold of me and says, I want you to pay attention. Let me show you what he told me to pay attention to. Here it is. You see the word 436. It says, I set against to withstand, I resist, oppose. Let me read this to you. Now, in my world, what's going on in the last two videos, this is very kind of out of character for what I do. But I'm taking a hard stand against all these people. I'm done with their nonsense. They've been running their mouths for over a year. The whole ARC thing that I'm the one that was willing to tell the people that came to the ministry that the Lord gave me, go support the ARC. It looks like a noble endeavor. I was the one that was putting money that was coming to me into the ARC. I was telling everybody, just go donate directly to them. If you want to help these people that have a place to stay, that's what we did. It's a fact. And fix the place up for other people. It went defunct. That's all that happened in the story. We can talk about the reasons and all that where for all in some other venue if we need to. However, right now, I am standing against all those people that for the last year have been running their mouths with hatred. Now, here's a word the Lord showed me just a little while ago. It says, means to forcefully declare one's personal conviction where they unswervingly stand, to keep one's possession, ardently withstand without giving up. In this part of the word was a military term in classical Greek, meaning to strongly resist an opponent, take a firm stand against your opponent. So here we go. And here's, you can go look at a whole bunch of different places in the Bible where it's used, but resist him firm in your faith. First Peter, to God, resist the devil. Okay. So, but he vigorously opposed our teaching. So these are different places where you see the same word that the Lord gave me, 436. And I'm going to show you how he gave it to me. And then he gave me 195, strictness, accuracy, exactness, attention to details. Okay, well, don't forget, this is the person that the Lord God used to decrypt the Vatican, to show you people drawing pictures of me with dead sheep on my head. Commercial after commercial, Maserati commercials, Bud Light commercials. Just go look at the litany of them. Folder, over 20, 30,000 images, I think. All pertinent to the Bible and what the Lord was teaching me. So I took my stand the other day. What's interesting is the word 436, I think it is, means to take one stand, which is what the Lord told me to do the other day, to take one stand, to stand against, opposite against, to stand properly, to take a complete stand against. There it is. See it? So let me show you. Do you think it's possible that I'm showing you that word? Watch this. I'm going to show you how the Lord gave me that word, and then you tell me how impossible this is. Ready? Let me show you where it is. You see 195 and 436 right there? 195 and 436. Let's see if you can catch it, because this is how the Lord showed it to me. This is the Don't Look Up trailer. Now, listen to me. I'm telling you, if I was on the Brood of Viper team, I would be freaking out of my mind right now. I'd be like, we're in trouble. Yeah, probably. Here we go. Ready?
This is not real. This is not real. This is not real. This isn't happening. Kate, tell me this isn't really happening.
I hear there's something you don't like the looks of.
We discovered a very large comet.
Oh, good for you.
It's headed directly towards Earth.
This comet is what we call a planet killer.
At this exact moment, I say we sit tight and assess.
Sit tight and assess?
Sit tight.
And then assess. The sit tight part comes first, then you gotta digest it. That's the assessment period.
This is the worst news in the history of humanity. He just blew us off.
What are we gonna... The worst news, and now, okay, now listen up, guys. Now, don't forget, this is just a video going in the folder to show you how society and how they're grooming everybody to don't look up. Just kind of like over at James's channel. Don't be waiting for God. Don't be looking for him. Don't be waiting. Here's this movie of Jordan Peele, you know, Nope, Don't Look Up. Here's Don't Look Up. It's all Don't Look Up. Why not? The Bible says, look up, for your redemption draweth nigh. When you see these things beginning to happen, look up. So the Lord sends me to take a stand against this guy, James the Planter, and against all the brood of vipers that are there supporting him, which is what I'm doing. Okay, I wonder how in the world I could show you 195 and 436 from what I'm showing you right now. Watch.
We have to release the information.
So we just leak it.
Our guests today have made a pretty big discovery in space.
How big is this thing, though? Like, can it destroy my ex-wife's house? Is that possible?
There's a 100% chance that we're all going to die.
Hey.
Well, the handsome astronomer can come back anytime, but the yelling lady, not so much.
We're going to get the news out there, one way or another.
It's real and it's coming.
FBI!
Jesus Christ, you could have just called me.
This comet contains $30 trillion worth of material.
What do trillions of dollars matter if we're all going to die?
Oh, no, this what is if we're rich? That would be terrible.
Get ready for the be-all, end-all. Okay, now, again, I'm putting this video in the folder just to show you, isn't it weird that they're coming up with these movies and these series that are titling saying, don't look up? Isn't it weird, David Bowie, Omicron, oh, you have to find the serial killer and it shows you up because that's the only way to find the serial killer in the system we call the Earth? I mean, isn't it fascinating? And here I am, the Lord telling me, take a stand against these people now, Jonathan. I'm like, all right, Lord. He told me for the last year to totally ignore all of them, which I did. Although we had people that were harvesting their comments from all these different places. And it was just vitriol. It's just hatred. That's all it is. So now, the Lord gives me the word 436 and 435 from that video, don't look up. Let me show you how. 195,000 comments, 436,000 shares. That's the end of the clip when they're doing this.
We're going to get the news out there one way or another.
It's real and it's coming.
Okay, you see that? Okay, well, it stops on the number I just showed you. It stops on 195 and 436. That's where the little ticker tape stops on. Well, again, the Lord taught me to read their language. Will Smith, iRobot, Detective Spooner, badge 4084. 4084 in the Bible is, I apprehend, catch, and arrest, because he's a detective, and that's what his badge number says. So I read their language. I've been reading it for a long time. Taylor Swift, Celia, I'm not going to go over it all. There's hundreds of examples now. The Lord's taught me to read the language of angels. I can read it. It's a language. Right here, 195 and 436, to take a stand against, a complete stand against, and strictness, accuracy, exactness to detail, attention, and scrupulousness. And what's going on in the Don't Look Up video trailer is the Earth is about to be destroyed, and it's an extinction level event. I wonder what the odds are on that. Do you think that's possible? Well, let me show you what happened today after we went and did our little physical training this morning. So we were driving back, and when we come back, there's an overpass, and there used to be this, I thought it was a blue cross, and it said, Yah, you know, when you see the same graffiti, and you drive by it every day, you remember kind of, oh yeah, that's where that graffiti is. And it was a cross and it said, Yah. But today, Zach noticed something very strange. This is, and it gets really strange. Watch this. Yeah, I mean, what happened is insane. Now I'm saying, what I'm telling you right now is be looking for the Lord God coming on the clouds of heaven. I'm telling you that. You're always supposed to be looking. You're always supposed to be ready. Keep your garments, be ready. Keep your garments. So when he shows up, you're ready to go in. You don't want to be in some doing the wrong thing, not paying attention, get off into some sin thing you shouldn't be doing. You should be keeping yourself ready and waiting for the Lord. And that's what this other channel was telling you, no, you don't need, if you think you're waiting for him or look, he's coming, you're, well, tempting God. That's what he said. So anyway, that's insane. He also said, you're not going to go meet the Lord in the clouds. It means air. It means breathing. He just totally negated the other words in the scripture. So I'm standing firmly against him. Isn't it weird that the number 436 means to take a complete stand against? Do you think I could open up some movie called Don't Look Up trailer that the Lord told me put that in there? Lord told me put that trailer in there. I'm like, okay, put it in there. And in Don't Look Up, it says take a firm, solid stance against and attention to detail. Look, there it is. Properly to take a complete stand against. Do you see it? Now, if you go read the comments from Karen and Kathy and Jim and all these other people and the whole Gene Rebel group and all the other haters, you can very easily say I stand completely against Johnny. That's in their comments. Jonathan is a false prophet. I'll say it over and over again. They say it over and over again. It's nothing but hate and vitriol. So the Lord tell me, now I want you just to stand up against them. That's what I did. Wonder what the odds are that in a movie that says Don't Look Up, that's in there. 436, to take a complete stand against. I wonder what about strictness, accuracy, attention to detail? And it's talking about the end being here. So what's the whole trailer about? It's the end of the world. And I've been telling you guys, it's the end of the world. That's who I am. That's my job. Tell you guys like Moses, hey guys, we need to leave. We're about to leave, Egypt. So trust me. What about Noah? Oh, I got to build this ark, man. It's going to be a lot of work. I'm the before the fire guy. I am the before the fire guy, right? Yes or no? How many times have y'all heard me say, Jonathan, this is it. 4, 3, 2, 1, before the fire. Did I say that? Yeah, no. It says we're going to meet the Lord in the clouds. Caught up with them together in the clouds. Caught up with them together in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Therefore, to always be with him, to ever be with the Lord. Okay, let me show you what he just showed me. Ready? Here we go. If you guys want to see the folder, it's right here. It's in the To Be a Witness Part 2 Serpent Eating Sheep folder. Okay, so here we go. Right here, this is what happened today, and we documented it. So that's Corey and Zach and I and Bowie going and doing our PT in the morning, going and doing our little physical training, keep things moving. And on the way back, Zach happens to notice and look over where that cross was that used to say, Yah, it's gone. And Zach notices it. Let me share that with you. Ask yourself, what are the odds? with what you're about to see right now, and then I'm going to take those odds and I'm going to destroy them so hard because something happened after that. It's just like, remember all the red letters disappearing in the comment I wrote to James? Remember? All the red letters disappeared, but James said, oh, that's because it left the word defending and that God's defending James. No, James, that's not at all what it means. Not at all. Okay, here we go. Ready?
Just doing this crazy little document. Was that?
Yep.
Corey in the back and Bowie in the back. What's up? Anyway, so yeah, we went and did a little PT, a little physical training this morning, and on the way back, we're talking about all this just insanity going on over at James Channel and watching the brood of vipers come out and just spit their vitriol out. Anyway, we're talking about the clouds and how the Bible declares what's going to happen and how this channel is going completely against the Bible. Then Zach looks up and notices something very interesting, and we're making a UE. We're going back to take a look and to document it right now. So again, like I said, we're coming back from our little outing this morning, and on the way back, and we've already driven by it, but we're going back to document it because y'all have to see this. So with all this thing going on about the cloud, you know, oh, you don't go up to the clouds. And I'm like, yeah, that's what the Bible says. And then he takes me to the art gallery and shows all the proselytes going up to the rock that has the cross emanating the light on it. And then he tells me to watch something called Arrival, where these entities turn to clouds and leave. It's just like crazy. But now, this morning, as we're just going through the same, you know, territory again, watch this. Okay, so I'm pulling up to basically the underpass where this is written. And this used to have some graffiti under the bridge, and I noticed it quite a while back. It said Yah, and I think it was across. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
It was Yah instead of cross. Bowie, is that right? Is that right? It was across.
It said Yah.
It was across. It said Yah. Yeah, during the Easter, during the recent Easter
holiday, whatever that word is.
And now we're going to go back and just show you what it is. I'm sorry, I'm trying to look at traffic and hold this phone and do all this. So anyway, we're about to take the underpass, so I'm going to change the view of this camera so you can see what we saw. And then just turn on Max McLean and let him read it to you. Okay, so we've made our little turnaround under the highway right there, and we're good. So this is where we were, and right over there where that
was. Okay, I'm going to pause it right there. See, it says Psalm 68 right there, and there's a crown. See it? Now watch this. It's kind of like the crown on the bridge in Black Rock, but check it out. That used to be a cross. I think it was blue, and the writing may have been black and said Yah. Anyway, but it's Psalm 68, and Zach noticed it. He goes, did you see Psalm 68? And then Zach presses Psalm 68 in the truck while we're driving. Now remember, James is like, oh, you don't go up to the clouds. No, that's not what it means. Okay, James. And then the Lord shows me a movie where an entity, a higher power, turns to a cloud. It's a door in time and turns to a cloud and leaves. But James is saying, nope, that's not the way it goes. But the Lord tells me, watch this movie. And in the movie, exactly what happens is turning to a cloud and leaving. Just saying, these are facts. And then the Lord tells me, you got to stand against these guys, Jonathan, for the well-being of the sheep. And I'm like, okay. And then he has me look at a trailer called Don't Look Up, because they're front-loading everybody's brain not to look up. And those of us, when it comes, you can't be holding on to your life. You got to be ready to let go of your life at that minute and look up and leave. If you're not ready to die when this happens, you're not ready to go. Do you understand? So I can see the enemy, Satan, doing movies, Don't Look Up, Jordan Peele, Nope, where no one will look up because there's a big evil cloud that's going to get you. So see, I see the enemy trying to front load society's brain. Don't look up. David Bowie, oh, go into Omicron, and then, oh, if you don't find the serial killer, then he gets your soul. And they put the word up there the whole time because they know, the devil knows, Satan knows when you turn things up, you can see the truth, and then you can get out of the rat trap that we're in. Okay, that's the way you get out of it. Okay, you turn to Christ, you return to Christ, he's up. You turn back to Christ, he's up. Okay, now, watch this, Psalm 68, there it is, we went back and documented it. It used to be a cross, used to say Yah. Here's the rest of the little video, then we're going to listen to Psalm 68, freak out.
White car is, that's where it used to say Yah. Let's see if it'll zero in on it. I'm having a focusing issue, there it is. It says Psalm 68. So now I'm going to drive towards it. Just got to wait for the traffic to go. So it says Psalm 68. And we're just sitting here talking about all this stuff. Y'all saw the video with the entities turning to clouds and leaving. And then as we're driving by right here, what used to say...
Okay, there's Psalm 68. Yah, see it right there? Psalm 68. Yah, see it? Okay, Zach just noticed that. Okay, when we came home from that, from me documenting it, and we came back to the house, I had another one. I've been having some headaches, probably with all the extra crap I'm dealing with. Anyway, so I lay down for a little while, and Zach decided to go back over there and take a photo to get, because all I had was my video, and we didn't know that I had a really clean photo. Let me show you what happened when Zach went back over there. Remember the red words disappearing in the comment I wrote to James, remember that? That all the red words disappeared? Yep. Okay, well, watch this. Look at what's going on in this folder. This is mind-boggling. Watch this. So Zach goes back over there to take a picture of Psalm 68 so we have a nice clean image of it. And he's going to send it to Dave to put into the folder. But when Zach gets over there to take a picture of it just a little while ago, check it out. They've gone over there and cleaned the whole wall. I mean, what? So let's see. Here we go. See, there it is. That was it. Let's see. And now I got it on my phone. Let's see. Where's my phone? I don't have my phone out here with me, but on my phone, that was it, whatever hour, 5 hours earlier, what you're looking at. Psalm 68, see it right there, Psalm 68, Yah. And then, a couple hours later, there it is. I wonder what the odds are on that it's disappeared, like the red, white writing. I don't know. But the Lord told me to take a hard stand against Gene Revel, Karen and Kathy and Jim, and anyone that supports all the nonsense and all the evil comments that they made that we've harvested. We've kept a pretty good library of it. It's all mean, ugly, cruel stuff. Anyway, so here we are. We're at a dividing line. We got the haters over here. We got the sheep over here. Let me show you the way this rolled out now. What's that? Okay, so y'all remember I'm the before the fire guy, right? Before the fire. I told you the Lord told me I had to name my ministry Before the Fire. This is it, 4321, Before the Fire. Okay, now, when I did the radio, when the Lord called me out. Now, here we go. I'm going to play Psalm 68, and I'm gonna go like this on the words while it's playing. Ready? Here we go.
Driven away, so drive them away. Psalm 68. Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered. Let them also that hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so drive them away. As wax melteth before the fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God. But let the righteous be glad. Let them rejoice before God. Yea, let them exceedingly rejoice. Sing unto God. Sing praises to his name. Extol him that rideth upon the heavens by his name, Jah, and rejoice before him. A father of the fatherless, and a judge of the widows is God in his holy habitation.
I'm going to pause it because it took my screen away for a sec. When I highlighted Yah, let me go back because I want you guys to see this. Do you think, let me ask you a question, just a personal question, all of you that are watching it. Do you think it's weird that as soon as I highlighted Yah, I'd already gone and done other words, but when I highlighted Yah, something happened and everything disappeared? Do you think that's weird that the red words disappeared? That Psalm 68 written on a highway in graffiti disappeared within a few hours of us videotaping it? Listen to what this psalm is about. Make sure you listen to all the words. It says that the Lord's coming now to stand against his enemies. Didn't he tell me to take a hard stand just a little while ago watching a trailer called Don't Look Up? And the Lord says, watch, freeze it at the end of those. And it says, take a stand against and attention to detail. Do you think that's even humanly possible, what I'm showing you? But then look at all the supernatural stuff the Lord lets me show you that's not even close to humanly possible. Two houses, the same rock, all that stuff. Just think about it. Now watch and listen again to Psalm 68. Did you see it all disappear? Do you think I did that on purpose or something? No, let's do it again. Psalm 68 from the beginning. Here we go. And
Psalm 68. Let God arise. Let his enemies be scattered. Let them also that hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so drive them away. As wax melteth before the fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God. But let the righteous be glad. Let them rejoice before God. Yea, let them exceedingly rejoice. Sing unto God. Sing praises to his name. Extol him that rideth upon the heavens by his name, Jah, and rejoice before him.
That's probably a coincidence.
A father of the fatherless, and a judge of the widows is God in his holy habitation. God setteth the solitary in families, he bringeth out those which are bound with chains, but the rebellious dwell in a dry land. O God, when thou wentest forth before thy people, when thou didst march through the wilderness, Selah, the earth shook, the heavens also dropped at the presence of God, even Sinai itself was moved at the presence of God, the God of Israel. Thou, O God, didst send a plentiful rain, whereby thou didst confirm thine inheritance when it was weary. Thy congregation hath dwelt therein. Thou, O God, hast prepared of thy goodness for the poor.
Amen.
The Lord gave the word. Great was the company of those that published it. Kings of armies did flee apace, and she that tarried at home divided the spoil. Though ye have lain among the pots, yet shall ye be as the wings of a dove covered with silver, and
wow,
the feathers with yellow gold. When the Almighty scattered kings in it, it was white as snow in Salmon. The hill of God is as the hill of Bashan, and high hill as the hill of Bashan. Why leap ye, ye high hills? This is the hill which God desireth to dwell in, yea, the Lord will dwell in it for ever. The chariots of God are 20,000, even thousands of angels.
That's my
the Lord is among them, as in Sinai, in the holy place. Thou hast ascended on high. Thou hast led captivity captive. Thou hast received gifts for men, yea, for the rebellious also, that the Lord God might dwell among them. Blessed be the Lord, who daily loadeth us with benefits, even the God of our salvation, Selah. He that is our God is the God of salvation, and unto God the Lord belong the issues from death. But God shall wound the head of his enemies, and the hairy scalp of such an one as goeth on still in his trespasses. The Lord said, I will bring again from Bashan, I will bring my people again from the depths of the sea, that thy foot may be dipped in the blood of thine enemies, and the tongue of thy dogs in the same. They have seen thy goings, O God, even the goings of my God, my King, in the sanctuary. The singers went before, the players on instruments followed after. Among them were the damsels playing with timbrels. Bless ye God in the congregations, even the Lord, from the fountain of Israel.
Get ready, guys.
There is little Benjamin with their ruler, the princes of Judah and their council, the princes of Zebulun and the princes of Naphtali. Thy God hath commanded thy strength. Strengthen, O God, that which thou hast wrought for us. Because of thy temple at Jerusalem shall kings bring presents unto thee. Rebuke the company of spearmen, the multitude of the bulls, with the calves of the people, till every one submit himself with pieces of silver. Scatter thou the people that delight in war. Princes shall come out of Egypt. Ethiopia shall soon stretch out her hands unto God. Sing unto God, ye kingdoms of the earth. O sing praises unto the Lord, Selah. To him that rideth upon the heavens of heavens, which were of old, lo, he doth send out his voice, and that a mighty voice. Ascribe ye strength unto God. His excellency is over Israel, and his strength is in the clouds.
And his strength is in the clouds. Wow, that's, wow, what an interesting thing to say at the end of it. And his strength is in the clouds. And it's about the Lord coming to destroy his enemies, all those that have stood against him. I'm just saying, either I'm a servant of the Most High or I'm not, one or the other. But there's a lot of people out there that are just running their mouths in hatred. They've been doing it for a long time. And all I ever did was try and help other people. That's it. Try and help people have a place to stay. That's what I did. And what was I returned for? Vitriol and hatred. That's what I got in return. Points me to Psalm 35. Anyway, so now we have all these miracles rolling out. Do you think that's a miracle that the Lord showed us Psalm 68? And if you read it, it's about the Lord coming out to destroy his enemies, coming against his enemies. It's a spiritual war. So the Lord says he's going to come out against his enemies. That's what it says. Those that are like James, you're putting out false words. People are out spewing hatred. Okay. Well, the Lord himself has a way of getting things done. He always does. When he took his people out of Egypt, he has a way of taking care of everything for everybody. He does it himself. So I submit to the Lord and whatever he wants to happen in the world for the entire world. But I can tell you this, the Vatican's a snake. Akhenaten is a snake eating the sheep, which is made up of a bunch of angels. So a serpent race is eating angels and their sheep. I've had people draw pictures of me with the dead sheep on my head with the serpent eating me. Not once, not twice. Three times I've gotten the same agenda. Okay, I mean, so that's not even remotely arguable. Okay, Jonathan Kleck was shown by the Lord there's a serpent race, aka like the Vatican, and the twin female energy from the pit. Hell hath enlarged herself. Her sins are piled as high as heaven. The time of her judgment has come. It's female, according to the word of God. Okay, so now we have this playing field that's all set up. Can you see it? Well, the Lord keeps pouring out supernatural miracles to me to show you. Was it a miracle that he showed me watch this movie, Arrival, and it's clouds leaving? Is that even possible when someone's saying you're not going up into the clouds? But the Lord says, watch this movie and it's clouds leaving, and the clouds are a higher power? That's not even humanly possible. It's like walking down a riverbed in Chinati and picking up two houses of the same rock. It's not even remotely possible. It's not even remotely possible to go and lay hands on someone when you saw a billboard that said, put your money where your miracle is, because she used to talk smack about people that did chemo, and there she is doing chemo. It's probably the chemo that was about to kill her, and the Lord had made sure she stopped. Okay, so now we have all this interesting playing field set up, and it's going to be one or the other. Either that group over there that supports James and his super awesome interpretation of the Bible, or it's the people that have seen all the miracles the Lord's wrought through me, supernatural healings, laying hands on the blind, laying hands on the sick. And there's a litany of people that are willing to come forward as witnesses that these things have happened and the Lord wrought those miracles through me. That's it. That's all there is to it. Either James and his haters are going to win, or the Lord God's going to show himself to be the one that's doing the deal, that's in control of the whole thing. Whatever it is going to be, that's it. It's that simple. I'll put my trust in the Lord God. Because how in the heck do you go see Psalm 68 and record it, and then a few hours later, Zach goes by and it's disappeared? And see, those guys over there are probably, oh, y'all went and did that. No, we don't do things like that. We don't have to. I serve the Lord God. He makes all things possible. See, he does the miracles. I don't have to go fake miracles. I'm sure you guys probably do stuff like that, but we don't. Not over here. All right. Time's here, guys. Something's going on. When I say time's here, oh, look like that time's here. It didn't happen. It's like, okay. What I mean is the time of the division is here. The time of the separation. You can see it throughout all of society. All you have to do is turn on the TV or go out in public. There's a division here. There's one that is just literally hates the other. The other one that's being hated is like, just like I ignored it for a solid year. Lord said, just ignore all of them. All of them. I'm like, yeah, okay, yeah, I don't really give them any oxygen. They can have their own self-licking ice cream cone party of hatred over there by themselves. That's good. But when that person, James, is doing videos that are hurting sheep like Debbie that left a really good comment how confused she was. Well, I have to stand up and protect the sheep. That's what a shepherd does. Now, see, Gene Rebel Channel thinks he's a shepherd, but all he does is hate videos. So he's not a shepherd of anything. He's just a mouthful of hate. That's it. So they don't do anything. They're not serving God's kingdom. But they say they are. But the Bible says in the end, they will heap up for themselves teachers to make their itching ears tingle. So anyway, we're all going to be judged. All of us, me, all of us. And I'm content with that. Judge me, Lord, according to your will, according to what's right. And I just mean that for everybody. So here's the thing. I think everybody, according to Jonathan Kleck and what I've been shown, y'all should start keeping an eye. Look up. For your redemption draweth nigh. When you see wars and rumors of wars, you know, the time is not yet, but you know it's coming, right? Have y'all seen wars and rumors of wars, famine and pestilence in diverse places? These kind of things? Are you seeing those things? I know those things have happened before in history, but have you noticed that this time in history is different than any other? In the end, a woman will compass a man. What do you think's going on right now? You think there's one energy compassing the other energy? See, it's energy. It's not your body or your genitalia. It's energy, male and female in opposition to each other within a host body system. That's what's going on. Okay, and the Lord's let me solve it, and he's confirmed to me that y'all should probably be watching and waiting. Don't listen to James. You should be watching and waiting. Don't listen to James when he says, oh, it's not a physical event. The Bible says it is. It says, look up. When you see these things begin to happen, look up. It says, every eye will see him. Hey, you men of Galilee, why stand ye there and look up and gazing up into heaven? The same Jesus that you saw go up will return in like manner. But James is saying, no, it's not a physical event. But he picks and chooses words that don't make, he doesn't even do it well. He doesn't put it together well at all to where it makes any sense whatsoever. I challenge you just to go listen to his videos. Can't understand it. Okay. Now, the lines have been drawn. Something's about to happen, I think. Don't you? All right. I love you guys in Christ. But I'm going to state the obvious now. I'm just going to state the obvious. This is just the obvious and what's happening. And these are the miracles that the Lord's doing over here. He's doing this as a miracle, as he's doing this as an answer to James saying, nope, you're not going to be caught up to the clouds. So the Lord tells me to watch some video or some movie where the clouds come as a higher entity, a door in time, and there the clouds go disappearing. Okay, so that would suggest that probably I'm hearing from the Lord, because the Lord's the one that told me to watch whatever the heck, arrival video. And it's the clouds leaving, but James is saying the clouds aren't leaving. You're not going up in the clouds. James is saying you're tempting God again if you're waiting for him. I'm telling you, you're supposed to be waiting for him. They have movies like Jordan Peele's Nope, Don't Look Up in the Clouds. What are they front-loading you? Is that Satan using a movie called Nope to front-loading you, making you scared to look up? There's other links to other videos that are about the same thing in the same folder. I don't want to go over them all, but it's all the same crap. Okay, you're supposed to be looking for the coming of the Lord. That's what we're waiting on. You're supposed to occupy till I come, so you're not supposed to just sit around and wait, but you're supposed to look for his arrival. You're always supposed to be ever ready. Joyful, expectant, waiting. Joyful, expecting, waiting. So I encourage all y'all to have joy in you. Look at the miracles he's doing here. I mean, really? Go to the art gallery where everyone's going up to the rock? Whatever. Really? I mean, every time he takes me to that art gallery, it's one crazy miracle. And then I end up going somewhere and some crazy supernatural things happen. So he took me to the art gallery, so I'm kind of on the edge. I think something crazy may be about to happen. Just saying. He found me the plane in the desert. He gave me the rocks in the desert. He took me to Black Rock. I think some people over at that channel are trying to say I manipulated that bridge. No, I didn't touch that bridge in any kind of way to write anything on it. It happened like that. That's the Lord whom I serve. He makes sure it happens like that. I don't have to do anything. He does it. That would show that you don't know God if you're saying that I manipulated the bridge. How could you possibly know God? Okay, now, because that's also a bearing false witness too. So, anyway, so here we go. Peace and grace to everybody, and I mean that, everybody. Peace and grace. The King, I believe, is coming right away. I just believe he's coming soon. Very soon. All right. Love you guys.